Thank you. Thank you. parents, guardians, families, friends, and staff. Welcome to the 2022 John Pulani Collegiate Institute Commencement Ceremony. My name is Ms. Silva. I'm the Assistant Curriculum Leader for Student Services, and tonight I am your Master of Ceremonies. To begin our ceremony this afternoon, I invite everyone to please stand as you are able and remain standing for the entrance procession of our graduates and platform party followed by the land acknowledgement and the playing of our national anthem. Please stand if you are able.
Thank you.
acknowledge we are hosted on the lands of the Mississaugas of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, and the Wendat. We also recognize the enduring presence of all First Nations, Métis, and the Inuit peoples. Graduating student Kyla Van, who is this year's salutatorian, for her address and welcome.
Hello, one and all. It's my honor to welcome staff, friends, and family to the John Polani graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. It's so amazing to scan the audience and see familiar faces, although we are looking much tidier than usual. When I first walked through these doors, I was uncertain whether this was the school for me. But within no time, the students, staff, and the proximity to Yorkdale eased my fears. The pandemic proved that we are a school that pulls together to weather any storm or virus, in this case, that comes our way. We are a resilient bunch, pivoting from online learning to in-person learning, back to online learning. To our families, thank you for your love and encouragement. We don't say it enough, but your support has helped us, especially during these unusual times. To my parents, thank you for instilling in me a strong work ethic and the confidence to know that I'm not alone. We, JPCI, are not alone. We have each other. And to quote our Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, we're all in this together. Thank you.
Thank you, Kyla. At this time, I am pleased to introduce our platform party. Each individual will stand when I call their name. We will start with the front row with Principal Margaret Greenberg. Trustee Shelley Laskin. Vice Principal Hema Gayadin. From the Rotary Club of Toronto Eglinton, the new president, David Richardson. Vice Principal Florence Ormond. And for the next group, I would like to introduce our ACLs. ACLs are assistant curriculum leaders in their area. I will start with Ms. Elborn James. She is the ACL of Technological Education. Ms. Lynn Abrams for Science. Mr. Imran Mohammed for Computer Studies, Business Studies, and Experiential Learning. Ms. Nikki Coleman for the Arts. Ms. Sarah Isaacs for Canadian and World Studies, Social Sciences and the Humanities, Ms. Varvara Akub for English, French, and Spanish, Mr. Ian Fraser for Special Education, Ms. Diane Melville for Mathematics, Ms. Shannon Burning for Health and Physical Education, Mr. Paul Savinetti for Athletics, Ms. Denise Costa for English as a Second Language, and Ms. Peggy Kwan, who is our ACL for Student Success. At this time, I would love to invite our trustee, Shelley Laskin, for her greetings from the board.
Thank you so much. It's really a pleasure to be here this afternoon with the 2022 graduating class. I'm proud to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Toronto District School Board. Graduates, even though I can't see you, we are here to honor your achievements. For the past 2 years, not only have you achieved success in public education, you've overcome a multitude of challenges the world has thrown at you, including a global pandemic. The pandemic changed the way we learn, we work, and live. It created obstacles that were new and unique, and it laid bare societal inequities. But you adapted and rose to the top. It was no easy feat, but you did it. And today you're able to experience this commencement like you've always imagined, surrounded by your friends and family, and with your teachers and administrators smiling broadly at you. We are also very proud. But before I address you, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the administration and staff at JPCI, both present and past, who have supported you reaching this accomplishment. For the rest of their lives, I'm sure no one wants to hear the word pivoting or unprecedented, but they supported you every way they knew how, while managing their own real life situations. And to your families, who did school in their homes while working themselves remotely or working on the front lines to help fight to keep us safe, but still managed to engage with us to support your success, we are very grateful. And to those parents in particular who've been part of school council and who are also graduating with their children, my sincere appreciation for your partnership. The world you are in, graduates, will continue to change, but more than ever, we are connected. We're a global community. Extraordinary change continues to happen, but what these past 2 years have taught us is that we can't always predict our future. But you're prepared, whether you know it or not. Sometimes you'll feel like crying. But your accomplishments in the arts and sciences, on the sports fields, computer labs, your academic achievements, your caring for others, your sense of community, all of that prepares you. Muhammad Ali, the famous boxer, had an unusual fighting style. He described it as float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. And it's not a bad attitude if you're dealing with constant change in the world, or actually being the change in the world. Remain subtle, flexible, and adaptable. Keep all your options open. Stay on your toes as you move on to university or college or the work stream. And when you're ready to make your mark, develop a laser-like focus and work hard to achieve that goal. Don't let anyone else tell you what you're capable of, because within you is great power. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. And take every opportunity. Don't let fears and self-doubt get in the way where you're going. The most rewarding parts of life sometime are overcoming the challenges. Work hard, make mistakes, learn, succeed, fail, try again, but whatever you do, keep going. You have so much to look forward to. And most importantly, stay kind, stay connected. And lastly, as you walk across the stage to get your well-earned diploma, flushed with anticipation for your futures, watched by your beaming teachers and families, I wish you every success. And I wish all of you, graduates, families, staff, a wonderful and safe summer. We're also very proud. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Laskin, for your wise words. Due to scheduling conflicts, our superintendent, Denise Humphreys, cannot attend, but she does send her regrets for not attending and absolutely her best wishes for the graduating students and their families. It is my pleasure to introduce our principal for her address to the graduates, guests, graduates, and staff, Principal Margaret Greenberg.
Hello to all the fantastic JPCI grads out there today. How are you feeling? Oh, come on, you're graduating. How's it going? There we go. Congratulations. So grads, I'm gonna be honest with you. The principal's speech usually follows a very particular format. It usually starts with some encouraging words that essentially summarize that you made it, which you did. So congratulations, you made it. Not only did you make it through high school, but you did it with grace, you did it with style, you did it with a whole lot of humor and a ton of hard work. So fantastic job. After the you did it portion, we usually go on to talk about you, but I'm not going to do that yet. Before I talk about you, I'd like to take a minute to talk about some other people, many of whom may be in this room right now. I want to talk to you about family. Not just the people that you share your genetics with, but your chosen family as well. Since March of 2020, we've heard the word isolation a lot, like a lot. We had to stay inside our living spaces. We spent a lot of our classes online in a virtual space. Most of our socializing was virtually as opposed to in person. But even then, and throughout all of that, you were not alone. You aren't alone now. You were, and still are, surrounded by people who love you, who believe in you, and who are here to support you during some tough times. And you know what? You loved, believed in, and supported other people as well. We are the best versions of ourselves when we hold each other up and are held up by others. And I want to take a moment today to thank and acknowledge all of the people who helped our amazing graduates during this journey. It's an honor to have you here today, and I'm privileged in the time that we get to spend together. So just before I move on, maybe we'll give everybody a round of applause. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for being here for each other and for being with us today. Okay, Jaguars, enough talk about other people. I'm gonna talk about you now. What can I say? You're great. You're clever. You're resilient. You're funny. You are some of the most wonderful characters that I have ever had the pleasure of working for. When I was graduating high school, just as you are now, I could not have possibly imagined the adventures I would go on, the challenges that I would face, the future that would unfold before me. Time is funny like that. We have this idea about what the coming days and years are going to look and how we're going to meet it when it comes, but it always has a way of surprising us. And while that time that comes may be unknown, that uncertainty doesn't make me nervous because I know that it's in good hands. That you, Jaguars, will help be the creators of a different world and guardians of a future that is less yet to be determined, but sure to hold wonderful things. You see things through your own unique perspective, and you will undoubtedly solve problems that have befuddled the generations that have come before you. So, no good graduation speech would be complete without some parting words of wisdom. So today I've chosen to leave you with a message from politician, lawyer, and activist Stacey Abrams. Thanks, a Stacey Abrams fan out there. Excellent. When we show up, act boldly, and practice the best ways to be wrong, we fail forward. No matter where we end up, we've grown from where we began. Class of 2022, keep showing up, keep growing, and have confidence in your greatness, as your success is sure to follow. Congratulations.
Thank you, Principal Greenberg, for your inspirational words. We will now recognize the students who have made significant contributions to the school community through their extracurricular activities, academics, and demonstration of character. The Goldie Feldman Scholarship is generously is being funded by Goldie Feldman for three JPCI graduating students. They will be awarded $5,000 each year, so this is not the first year. This fund is being continued through Goldie Feldman's generosity. A long time ago, Ms. Feldman's children attended school in this building, when at that time it was called Bathurst Heights, and has decided to support this community with a scholarship for our students. The three chosen students have met the scholarship criteria by demonstrating a strong commitment to their academics, are active in volunteering and or extracurriculars, and have overcome a personal struggle. I invite Principal Greenberg to present the scholarships to Gleb Bobrikov, John Delizo, and Sharania Shriharan. Can the three students come to the podium? Congratulations. Our next award is being sponsored by the Rotary Club of Toronto Eglinton. Dr. John McLean was a charter member of the Rotary Club of Toronto Eglinton and enjoyed a distinguished career in medicine. After serving as a pediatrician at the Hospital for Sick Children, he moved to the Holland Bloomsbury Children's Hospital, where he oversaw four decades of innovative advancements in pediatrics and rehabilitative medicine. In 2016, the Rotary Club of Toronto Eglinton established an award in his memory at John Polanyi Collegiate Institute. The scholarship is awarded annually to a graduating student who plans to attend a university or college in a health science program. The student should have outstanding achievement in math and science. I invite David Richardson to present this award to Masha Kostakova. The next award is also sponsored by the Rotary Club of Toronto Eglinton. It's the Lou Cooper Music Award. Lou Cooper himself was an active member of the Toronto Eglinton Rotary Club for many years. He is remembered for his huge smile, the devilish sparkle in his eye as he waited for an opportunity to share a joke or funny story. His early love of music led to a wonderful entrepreneurial venture in the music business for almost 30 years, while providing an opportunity to meet many like-minded people who shared his love of jazz. To remember his life as a Rotarian, the Toronto Eglinton Rotary Club, along with his wife, Barbara, and daughter, Tracy Cooper, and her husband, John Fredrickson, they have established an award in his memory. The award, known as the Lou Cooper Award, is given out annually at John Polanyi Collegiate Institute to a student who, in the opinion of the music teachers, has contributed most to bring joy to the student body through their music talents. Our recipient this year has definitely done that. I invite David Richardson to present the award to Jamai Cooper. Yeah! Stay. Shiva Pancham Memorial Award for Music. Shiva was one of our school-based safety monitors who unexpectedly passed away last year. We all still vividly remember his huge smile, zest for life, and love for his family, JPCI students and staff. We remember his contributions, whether it be in supporting students, being a cricket coach, or his many stories and anecdotes he loved to share with us all. His family set up a fund in his loving memory for two deserving and graduating students. This first award is awarded to a student who demonstrates a passion for music and financial need. I invite Vice Principal Gaia Dean to present this award to Jamai Cooper. The second award is awarded to a graduating student with special education needs who has demonstrated strong character and hard work. I invite Vice Principal Gaia Dean to present the award to Vijay Satkunanurthan. The Eamon Flahat Award for Leadership Excellence. This is an award named for our previous principal, and it goes to one female and one male student who display leadership and resilience and have made a difference at JPCI. I invite Vice Principal Armand to present the awards to Samantha Fortuna and Jamal Barabulubu. Congratulations. The Ontario Principals Council has an award called Principals Award for Student Leadership. This award is given to a student who demonstrates exemplary leadership and commitment to the school and is an excellent role model for their colleagues. I invite Principal Greenberg to present the award to Shaviv John. The Schulich Leader Scholarship nominee. This is awarded to a graduating student planning to enroll in an eligible STEM program at one of the scholarship's partner universities, has academic excellence, leadership, charisma, and creativity. They must be entrepreneurial minded and intend to pursue a career in one or more of the following foci areas: either technology, engineering, entrepreneurship, and business enterprise, applied scientific research. I invite Vice Principal Gaia Dean to present this award to Kyla Van. The Governor General's Academic Medal. The Governor General's Academic Medal, established in 1873, recognizes students who have achieved the highest academic average. Our recipient achieved an astounding 97.5% average. On behalf of the Governor General of Canada, Principal Greenberg is pleased to present the Academic Medal to Sharania Sriharan. There is a medal with the Governor General's picture on it, but she was just newly appointed, so they're still minting the medal, and it can be picked up, Sharania, in the fall. That's when we're expecting it. The One City Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to students who have excelled academically despite facing substantial obstacles. I invite Vice Principal Armand to present the scholarship to Rachel Bates. Our next group of awards is our department awards. Each recipient that will be coming forward has achieved the highest mark above 80% or higher in the course. For this group, I will be calling the ACL of the department to come forward and receive the certificates. Ms. Coleman will present the arts awards. For dramatic art, there's actually a three-way tie. Can the following students please move forward? And congratulations, Rana Hamoud, Shaviv John, and Zane Passion. Okay, congratulations. Just a reminder to ACLs for pictures, please take center stage. For visual arts, Rachel Bates. The next award is a visual arts award. It's called visual design, but really it's the yearbook. These students create, design, and produce the yearbook. And the award goes to Thivani Thirukaramaran. And the final award for the Arts Department is a Visual Arts Award for Photography, and the recipient is Ikhlas Abdullahi. Thank you, Ms. Coleman. Mr. Muhammad will now present the next group of awards. For financial accounting principles, there was a two-way tie, so will both Randy Law and Andrew Pham please come to the stage. For International Business Fundamentals, there was another two-way tie, Rachel Bates and Janine Leguesma. For the next award, it is the Business Leadership Management Fundamentals. The recipient's not here, but I would love to announce his name, which is Vishva Patel. And the last award for Mr. Muhammad's group is Computer Science. Will Jet Thompson Davidson please approach the stage? I now bring to the podium to the area Ms. Isaacs. And we're going to do the Canadian and World Studies, Social Science, and Humanities. The first one, the recipient for the World History since the 15th century is Rachel Bates. For the next one, which is Canadian and International Law, there was two winners for a tie, Janine Leguesma and Jerome Ramos. Janine, stay close by. For nutrition and health, please welcome to the stage. The recipient is Sharania Shriharan. For food and healthy living, Citra Mahadin. For families in Canada at the college preparation level, we have Arabella Ajatina. For families in Canada at the university preparation level, we have John DeLisle and Janine Leguizma. Miss Isaacs, do you mind if I just switch the order so she doesn't have to wait so long? Okay. I'm just going to skip to for criminology and criminal justice. There was a two-way tie between Janine Leguizma and Zane Passion. Congratulations. Thank you, Janine. For challenge and change in society, a two-way tie for Rana Hamoud and Jet Thompson Davidson. Thank you, Ms. Isaacs. And now I invite Ms. Hukub to the presentation rectangle to present for English and French. For English at the college preparation level, our recipient is Issa Daquingan. For English at the university preparation level, we have a two-way tie. Please welcome to the stage Arkana Nalalanathan and Sharanya Sriharan. For our writer's craft, the recipient is Samantha Fortuna. For Core French, we have Joel Tolentino. Thank you, Ms. Hakoub. And now I call Mr. Fraser to the presentation area. The recipient of the Advanced Learning Strategies Award is Kingsley Cordova. Thank you, Mr. Fraser. And now I call Ms. Malil to the presentation area. The recipient for the Foundations for College Mathematics is Issa Daquingan. I'm going to save this young student some steps. For the Calculus and Vectors Award and the Advanced Functions Award, the recipient for both awards is Masha Kostakova. And the final mathematics award for Mathematics of Data Management, the recipient is Sharanya Sriharan. Thank you, Ms. Malil. I now invite Ms. Burney to the presentation area. There was a three-way tie for healthy living and personal and fitness activities. They are Archana Nalanathan, Jerome Ramos, and Kai Zabitsky. For healthy, active living education, we have another three-way tie. We have Issa Daquengan, Margaret Rabara, and Nguyen Qua Hu Nguyen. And the final award for our department here is Introductory Kinesiology, and the recipient is Samantha Fortuna. Thank you, Ms. Burney. And now I invite Ms. Abrams to the presentation area. The next graduate has won two science awards. The first is biology, and the second is chemistry. Please welcome Masha Kostakova to this podium. For the physics course at the college level, we have Earl Fabergar. And for the final science award, we have an amazing three-way tie. For the physics at the university level, we have Randy Law, Kyla Van, and Kai Zabitsky. Thank you, Ms. Abrams, and I call now Ms. Elborn James to the presentation area. For technological design, the recipient is Cameron Wolfe. For our final department award, for hairstyling and aesthetics, we have Issa Dequigwin. Congratulations to all the recipients. It is now our pleasure to begin the presentation of the Ontario Secondary School Diplomas to our graduates. I would like to ask all attendees, as we present the graduates, to please remain seated. As you've noticed, we have a professional photographer taking pictures, and it will be shared with the students, and pictures are taken as they walk across the stage and shake hands with Principal Greenberg. We ask all family members again to please remain seated so as not to disrupt the viewing of others. In order to be awarded the Ontario Secondary School Diploma, a student must pass the Ontario Secondary School Literacy Test, complete 40 hours of volunteer work, and successfully attain 30 credits. Please note that this year, the literacy requirement was waived, yes, and the hours were reduced to 20 due to COVID, sorry. Among our graduates, we also have some accomplishments that we would like to highlight. First of all, 45 of these students that are walking across the stage have earned the Ontario Scholar Certificate. You may find their names listed towards the end of the program. These students accomplished an average of 80% or higher, and they will receive an additional certificate, the Ontario Scholar Certificate. Secondly, there are about 6 students who have successfully completed the specialist high skills major requirements, which include a co-op placement, certifications, and a bundle of credits specific to their industry. They will receive a special diploma with a red seal that is recognized by colleges and universities. Their names are also listed at the back of the program, and you will notice that they are wearing a red stole over their gown. And finally, also listed on the same page of the program are our science, math, and robotics students who earned a specific certificate through a bundle of credits they completed in enriched, advanced placement, and special courses. I would like to thank, before we start, the marshals and the readers who will be coming up, their staff members, to read the names. In alpha order, they are Ms. Britton, Mr. Isabai, Ms. Lee, Mr. Phillips, Ms. Rocchio, Mr. Sura, Ms. George, and Ms. Willen. I would like to now invite Ms. Britton to start the procession here.
We'll start with the first student, please. First up, we have Hajar Abadi. Hajar is receiving her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She's also an Ontario Scholar. She's heading off to university for psychology. Her message for everyone today is that she would never have believed a year ago that she would get this far. She has worked so hard, and she'd like to thank all her amazing grade 12 teachers. Next, we have Liban Adan. Liban is graduating with an Ontario Secondary School Diploma. His message today is that he would like to make his family happy. Next, we have Hanifa Alam. Next is Janelle Balbuena. She is receiving her Ontario Secondary School Diploma, and her message today is thank you to everyone at JPCI. Next, we have Roxana DiFrancesco. Her message is that the best is yet to come. Next, we have Mariano Ninobla II. He's receiving his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. His message today is thanking everyone and good luck to everyone on their journey. Next, we have Joelle Tolentino. He's receiving his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He is also a Ontario Scholar. His message is letting everybody know that he is the originator of style over joy. Next up, we have Kyla Van. Kyla is receiving her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She is an Ontario Scholar, and she's graduating from our SMR program. And I am finished, thank you.
All right, come sweetie. Roya Al-Ayan. All right, we'll be studying and enjoying life. Jamal Badarabu. All right, we'll be attending Seneca College for business commerce. I'd like to give a big shout out and thanks to my family and friends. One second. Hillary Barrett will spend a lot of time drawing and writing. Gleb Bobrikov will be attending York University for engineering. All right, I gotta hit this. I'm out of there, Jerry, and I'm loving every minute of it. All right, Cosmo Kramer, you wanna give a shout out to him? Daniel Del Castillo Mora will be attending Seneca College for Business Management. Kevin Huang, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, it's finally over. All right, that's definitely Kevin right there. All right, my girl, Shaviv John, all right. OSSD, Ontario Scholar. She will be attending York University for concurrent education. One day she'll be up here handing out diplomas. Shout out to my family, teachers, close friends, and peers. Without you, we couldn't have made it. All right. Julia Pham, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Ontario Scholar. My girl will be spending a lot of time in nature, where she loves it. There it is. James Robertson, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Ontario Scholar, SMR, will be attending Carleton for computer science. And this is the second time he wrote it. It all fell apart in the second half, but we won anyway. All right, James, we said it. All right, my boy Rayvon Robinson. All right, going to spend a lot of time on his BMX bike. That's what he's gonna be doing. Big shout out to family and friends. You know he has the biggest smile in the room. He's just playing hard right now. All right, Jet Thompson Davidson, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Ontario Scholar, SMR. This was supposed to be the summer of George, right? There it is, right there. Cameron Wolf, Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Do I gotta do this together or separate? You tell me. All right. Kai Zabitsky, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Ontario Scholar, SMR. She'll be studying mechanical engineering at the University of Toronto. Can I skip this one or no? All right, no, I'm just joking. Zev Zabitsky, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, will be pursuing an NCAA scholarship in basketball, and now track is his new love at Central Tech next year. Thank you, everyone.
The next one is Roy Crowell. Okay. His message is this: I would like to thank everyone in the school and my family. Isa Dikongang. She's receiving Ontario Secondary Diploma. Okay, the next one is Peter Gandaya. Okay. High school was fine, that's his message. Okay, Dana Joy Lydia. Message is, personal goal is to be happy till the end. I would like to thank my friends for keeping my high school years exciting. Next one is Wayne Leonardo. Wayne's message is, memories will stay, but life will move on. Thank you. See you soon, and congrats to all those who graduated. Next one is Margarita Ribora. Her message is, I want to thank my parents, friends, especially my saviors, Jesus Christ, because without them, I wouldn't be here. Next one is Margarita Ribora. Her message is, I want to thank all the teachers, my friends, especially my family. I love you guys. Sweetheart. Okay. Next one is Michael Sarah. Michael! Michael's message is always late, but still managed to graduate. Okay. Next one is Ariel Takura. His message is nothing is impossible. The word itself says I'm possible. Okay. Next one is Grace. Tablacook. Grace will be continuing her post-secondary education through Seneca at York this September. Grace would like to thank her family, teachers, and friends for the support she has received over the past 4 years. Oh. Okay, next one is Samir Miller. Okay. Samir's message is, thank you for believing in me, Mom. Now it's my time to accomplish great things. Oh, where's your card? Okay. Yeah, the next one is Andrea Alea. Okay, I don't have the card. Yes.
Good afternoon. I'd like to introduce you to Obson Better. His message is, I want to thank my family and friends. Without them, this would not be possible. That's my Elijah Brown. I didn't know what to say about myself, but y'all know who I am, Elijah Brown. John Daimler DeLizzo, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Anthony Waugh, OSSD, Ontario Scholar, and SMR. Eva Kovach. Quentin Morgan, too easy. Ali. Ali Musavi. Don't have too many people in my corner, but the people that I do have are well worth dying for, very deep. Archana. Nally Nathan, SHSM, Ontario Scholar, SMR. She will be going to the University of Toronto, seeking her BBA. I would like to thank all JPCI teachers for all the support and encouragement. Vivian Nguyen, I want to send a big thanks to all of the teachers and all of my friends. I will forever remember the memories that we went through. Jerome Ramos. I want to thank everyone for their undying support. Thank you for 4 years, Jaguars. See you, York University, you Lions. Rawr! Rivka Rubinoff. Rivka will be attending Humber College in the fall. Alex Tran. Jungle Gap. OSSD and Ontario Scholar. Thank you. Akila Abdullahi, Ontario Scholar, OSSD. Going to the University of Toronto, Mississauga for Forensic Science.
Good afternoon, everyone. Abdi Rizak Ali, OSSD. Sorry, quite a few people came. Sorry, a message from Abdi Rizak. Alhamdulillahi, just want to thank my mom. We now have Fatoumata Bakili, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Ryerson University for Business Management in September. She would like to thank her mom for being so supportive and always reassuring that she can do it. Thank you, Masese, for being Fatou's motivation. Rachel Bates, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. I feel so honored for all the amazing support from teachers, family, and friends. With their guidance, I'm excited to start the next chapters of my life. Thank you. Carol Ann Berteman, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Her message is, thank you, JPCI. See you. Let's share our dreams, Jaguars. Quoc Trong Deo, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. His message is, I had fun. JPCI rocks. Nawal El Nagi, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Her message is, I hid plastic mini babies around the school. So that's who it was. It was Nawal. Bushra Hassan, OSSD. Her message is, with grace, I simply say I wouldn't do it again, but I'm happy it happened this time. Thien Trang Hua, OSSD. Her message is, I had fun, and I hope all JPCI much success in the future. Thank you so much. John Ramir Iglesia, OSSD. Tiffany Ip, OSSD. Rajith Jayuraja, OSSD. His message is, thank you to my family, friends, peers, and teachers for helping me reach this point in my life. Masha Kostakova, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Her message is, I would like to thank all my teachers for their kindness and support that helped me to get through a long path in school. Also, I would like to thank my parents for their patience and support in hard times throughout the school years. Ilona Kovacs, OSSD. Randy La, OSSD, Ontario Scholar, SMR. Tahir Mahmood, OSSD, Ontario Scholar, SMR. His message is, heading off to Ontario Tech for engineering. Made amazing memories. Thank you to all for that. Kayla Ann Moore Williams, OSSD. Her message is, I'm finally done with school and taking the gap year I deserve. Camille Munez de Oliveira, OSSD. Her message is waiting for that STEM money to hit. Saleya Nabiar, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. She is attending the Ted Rogers Business Management Program at Ryerson University with the hopes of starting her own business one day. Abdullah Osman, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. His message is, shout out to Hoyo and Abu. Than Nam An Nguyen, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. His message is, thank you to everyone that I've had the chance to become friends with. Thank you to my teachers who have supported me through my journey. Good luck to everyone and their future. Andrew Pham, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. A few key words from Andrew: gaslight, gatekeep, girl boss. Vijay Satkunamurthy, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Alex Stobie, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. He will be attending McMaster in Life Sciences. His message is, I would like to thank my family and teachers for making today possible. Hope we all meet again.
Good afternoon, Jaguars. So first up, we have Nicarat Andy, who would like Ashley specifically to know. You brought me sunshine when I only saw rain. You brought me laughter when I only felt pain. Charles Stephen Antolin, receiving his OSSD. I'll continue Zeiss's legacy. Livia Brito Kunha, I thank my teachers for helping me to get to this day. Alden De La Cruz, you and you alone are the only person who can live the life that can write the story that we're meant to tell. Ashley Valentina James Elba, wherever you go with all your heart. Audrey Roses James, receiving her OSSD. Thanks to my family for always supporting me.
Good afternoon. Jemai Cooper, OSSD. Jemai is going to Centennial College for Automotive Parts and Service Operations. His message is, to my classmates in grade 10 science, y'all want something from the gas station? Samantha Fortuna, SHSM, Ontario Scholar. Samantha is going off to bigger things studying kinesiology and health science, then concurrent program at York University. Wouldn't have done it without my friends and family. All love with Sam. Rana Hamoud, OSSD, Ontario Scholar SMR. Her message is, big thanks to my parents and family for helping me throughout high school. I will attend Ryerson this upcoming semester for computer science. Next student is Janine Leguesma, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Her message is, she would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers. Peace out. Samuel Levi Arunsky, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. He's heading to TMU for Urban and Regional Planning. Take pride in how far you've come, have faith in how far you can go, but don't forget to enjoy the journey. Michael Josephson. Citra Muhideen, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. Ryerson University for Social Work. She would like to thank her parents, grandma, for continuously believing in and supporting her. Aline Norohamadi, OSSD, Ontario Scholar, SMR. Her message is going to the middle of nowhere. Zane Paolo Pachon, OSSD, Ontario Scholar. His message is it a guy? Is it a girl? Nah, it's just Zane. Jennifer Pham, OSSD. Her message is big adventures ahead. Sharania Sriharan, SHSM, Ontario Scholar. Sharania will be attending the Schulich School of Business in September. Devani Thirukumaran, SHSM, Ontario Scholar. Her message is take life easy, life's short. Sam Tran.
And we have the last group of amazing grads. Arabella Argentina, OSSD. Jerome A, OSSD, OS, 6.5 out of 10. Jermé Balogé, Sarah Brody, OSSD. Cordova, OSSD. It is an honor to be here on such a special occasion. I would like to begin by thanking all my friends, family, and most importantly, my mom, who has been there for me and has helped me every step of the way. Aya Cristobal, OSSD, attending Seneca College in Nursing. Thank you to my friends and family. Delicia Bernard. Yeah. All right, I got this. Oh, you got her. Earl Habegar, OSSD. Future electrician will pursue studies in trades. Girls are temporary, the bros are forever. Thank you, all my friends, for being amazing. Dorian Francois, OSSD, OS, Black Lives Matter. Malik Jalzucker, OSSD, a life without knowledge is a life incomplete. Antoinette Guy, OSSD, OS. Hannah Malafat. Thank you all for giving me experiences and lessons I needed to gain. Not just the ones necessary to graduate, but the ones I will take with me for life. Jennifer Sow, OSSD. Last but not least, Ashiba Shah, OSSD. thank you to all the graduates.
All right, grads, there's a little bit of a graduation tradition. Once you've got these caps on and you've walked across the stage, it's time to take your tassel and move it from one side, which is potential grad, to the other side, which is graduate. Congratulations, class of 2022.
At this time, I would love to invite Ms. Burney to the podium to introduce this year's valedictorian and present her with her award.
Thank you, Ms. Silva. This afternoon, I have the absolute honor and privilege of introducing this year's valedictorian. I first met Samantha when she was in grade 9 and I taught her Introduction to Personal Fitness. She amazed me with her perseverance, passion, and sheer enthusiasm for learning. I was also super impressed by how many push-ups she could do. I have since taught her in 5 other courses where she continued to excel beyond the course expectations and easily earned 3 perfect grades of 100% and 2 99%. Impressive, I know. Yes. She has been on the honor roll for many semesters and is graduating with a specialist high skills major in health and wellness. Samantha's extracurricular involvements during her time at JPCI have reached far and wide, from athletics, where she was a member of the cross country, cricket, volleyball, badminton, ultimate, and soccer teams, as well as being past vice president and current president of our athletic council, all the way to JPCI City and prom committee, just to name a few. Outside of JPCI, she has volunteered at Elevate Health Clinic, where she assisted patients in their rehabilitation programs, and has volunteered at Baycrest Hospital as a program assistant for seniors. It goes without saying that she is brilliant, hardworking, and a talented student and athlete, and one of the most awesome human beings I know. So, before she leaves the halls of JPCI to pursue a concurrent degree in kin and ed from York University, please join me in welcoming Samantha Fortuna to the stage for the valedictorian address.
Good afternoon, and please join me in welcoming my fellow graduates, family, friends, staff, and guests to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2022. It has been a long and interesting 4 years, but look at us now, we made it. I would like to start thanking the teachers and staff who have organized this special occasion. I also want to thank the parents and guests who made time to be here. And of course, I want to congratulate all of my fellow classmates because you finally did it. All of your hard work and sacrifices have paid off. Can we please have a round of applause for all of our incredible JPCI graduates? First of all, I have to thank those who have taught us. They are some of the most influential individuals in our lives. Teachers and support staff are the ones who have left a mark on us, and whether it was school-related or not, I know we all learned something valuable that will help us one day in our personal and academic endeavors. I want all of you to know that we appreciate every effort you made to make learning better for your students. We will remember your constant support, encouragement, and how patient and understanding each one of you were. You have completed your task of training your jaguars, and now we're finally ready to run. Now to those who have been there since day one, our parents, where do I even begin? You have been there every step of the way. Now raising a teen is not easy. Sometimes it could be a little bit rocky, but you continue to be understanding and be patient with us. Most of all, you never fail to show us your unconditional love. Even the little things you do for us are very well appreciated. Maybe your dad helped you put on a tie, or maybe your mom helped you do your hair. Or as my mom did, she helped me pick out my graduation dress. Parents, no amount of words will be enough to tell you how grateful we are. Thank you for never giving up on us and for always being there. Now, let's take a little trip down memory lane. Back to grade 9. It was the beginning of something new, and it was a time full of possibilities. It was a time when we caught a glimpse of ourselves, of what we liked, what we were good at, and what we needed to work on. Although grade 9 was an awkward stage of our lives, it was a stage that introduced us to new passions, new friends, and maybe even new habits like saying fam 20 times a day. So many memories were made during this time. Like maybe you remember participating in winter activity day. There were many activities such as skating, indoor soccer, and even snowboarding and skiing. Or maybe you recall going to the Toronto Zoo on a rainy day, or randomly having a karaoke session in the CAF during lunch. I personally remember playing Uno during class. I'm definitely gonna miss doing that. Then we moved on to grade 10, which turned out to be such an unpredictable year that changed our lives in so many ways. It was on March 11th, 2020, when COVID-19 was declared a pandemic, a word full of fear and uncertainty. Days later, schools closed and were moved to virtual learning, which was probably a relief for students because we thought we would have an extended March break. Later on, we realized it would be a major adjustment that we would have to get used to. Online learning was a whole new experience for all of us. Sometimes it was hard to focus through a screen, and there was a huge loss of social contact. And even just attending school in the comfort of your home can be quite distracting. For me, I was always distracted by either my phone, the TV, or the fridge. Yeah, the fridge was my best friend at the point. Even though the end of grade 10 was hard and not ideal, we still pushed through and persevered, and that's something we should all be proud of. September 2021, we moved into our grade 11th year. In some ways, grade 11 was not really any different. We were still online with some in-person classes. Some people completely hated being online, while some enjoyed it. I personally was neutral about it. I liked it, but I also missed seeing friends and my teachers. But I guess being online had its perks, you know? Waking up 2 minutes before logging into class, turning off your camera, muting yourself, and then rolling back into bed. Yeah, man, those were the good times, let me tell you. I had the best sleeps of my life. Overall, grade 11 was full of experiences that allowed us to get closer to family and even ourselves. Finally, we made it to our last year of high school, grade 12. It was a time when we returned to in-person learning, and even though it was not a perfect bounce back, we regained a sense of normality. We were able to see friends and teachers again, join clubs and sports and participate in spirit weeks, and even attend the athletic banquet. There are so many things to remember, like the $3 lunches, see? Whoever came up with that, thank you for realizing that your students were broke. Yeah. Anyways, you all have been through and learned so much. You are resilient, and although the coronavirus is still making history, Jaguars, we are too. JPCI graduates, we did it. We have successfully achieved one of the important milestones in our lives. This is a major step in the journey of our lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. It is an act not only of personal commitment, but also one of pride. We all worked hard to get to this day, and our efforts were not in vain. But graduation is not an end goal in itself. It is instead part of the larger journey of life. I know some people would say that this is the end of the chapter and then on to the next, but really this is the end of the book. And since our journey through high school has now come to a close, we have finished this book that we have written. Now we're ready to write a whole other book filled with new memories, lessons, relationships, plot twists, and fun. Life is about growing and taking on opportunities to learn new skills that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives. Don't be afraid to take on opportunities, even if sometimes it's scary, because without risk, there's no story. Continue to lead with purpose, and passion will follow. If you do something that makes you happy, it doesn't have to make sense to anybody else. It just has to make sense to you and feel right in your heart. Class of 2022, it has been a long journey, and from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very best. In closing, let me finish with a quote from my girl Beyonce. If you work hard, whatever you want, it will come to you. I know that's easier said than done, but keep trying. Thank you, and for the last time, go Jaguars.
Thank you, Samantha. That was so beautiful. We would like to acknowledge some very special people without whom a wonderful celebration like this could not take place. First, a very thank you to the families, caring adults, and JPCI staff represented here today on stage, in the crowds, and there's some staff members out in the back. They're all over the place. We know how important you are in the lives of these graduates, and we know that you have supported these graduates in many ways. Thank you for being their cheerleaders. Secondly, a very big thank you to the people who have planned, organized, and coordinated this ceremony tonight. There's been a lot of work done prior to today, a lot of work done behind the scenes. There's staff and members all over this building putting this night together. Thank you all so much. For this, without you, this would not happen. Special mention goes out to our stage crew. They're managing the lights, the sound, and the setup here. They're under the direction of Mr. Mohammed. Thank you, job well done. Now some final instructions to our graduates. Please be sure to return your gown. You may keep your cap and tassel. When you return your gown at the end of one side of the large gym, you now may proceed to the other side of the gym to pick up your diploma. So please return just your gown and you will get your diploma afterwards. Guests are kindly asked to remain at their seats. The platform party will leave first and the students will follow. Parents, guardians, relatives, and well-wishers, this concludes the ceremony for the graduating class of 2022 at JPCI. I would like to thank all of you for attending this afternoon, and congratulations to all our graduates. Thank you.
Yeah.